We are so happy to have you here for our very last assembly of the year, the spring ensemble, if you will, because there are many, many activities going on. We are going to get started, as you can see, with our violin and cello students, our third graders. Miss Longo has been working with them all year long. But I would like to just point out a couple of things. Mr. Lewis, thank you very much for recording. This is going to be on film and probably ready to go by, what'd you say, the end of the day? No? Too soon? Okay. Maybe in about a week or so, maybe in 2 weeks, on a loop on our local cable channels, you can see your children over and over and over again. So we thank you, Mr. Lewis, for being here. I would ask that if it gets a little bit too warm, that anyone who's sitting by that back door, if you wanted to open those two doors, you're certainly welcome to do that. Thank you very much. And then I would just ask that you keep an eye on where our exits are, two in the back, two in the front. In the event that we had to have any type of an evacuation, you now know where you're going. I would ask that you, if you're using your phone for a recording device, that's fine. If you have your phone and it's on a ringer, if you could please put it to vibrate or turn it off, that would be fine as well. I was at a performance a couple of weeks ago and the students were singing and somebody's phone went off and you thought that would have been the message to everyone else saying, "Ooh, my phone." And three phone rings later, somebody else had theirs go off. So if you could put your phone on vibrate, that would certainly help our performers today, I am sure. Can you imagine if the violin started playing some of the phone tones that you have? Without any further delay, boys and girls, you are in for a treat. We have violins, we have cellos, we have ballet performers, we have dancing and singing, and in a little bit we're going to bring the Maypole out and you will see the spring dances. And with any luck, we've seen the last of the rain for a little bit, at least until Sunday anyway. Miss Longo has been working with our students. You're going to hear the results of how wonderful they are. If we can please give a huge Highview round of applause to Miss Longo and our cellists and our violinists. And if anyone would like to sit after these performances, there are more chairs over here on the right side of the gym. Thank you. Let's hear it for our violins, our cellos, our third grade performers of this roundup. Excellent, excellent job, boys and girls. Just a reminder for those of us who have walked in, if you would like a seat, there are more spots over here opened up on the right side. You could either come in through the back or go back around the school and come in through the open doors and you can find a spot. We have more seats for you. Boys and girls, you were terrific. And as we are getting set up for our next round of performers, I'm going to ask Miss Burnaby to so a slight adjustment to the program. As you can see, the ballerinas are supposed to be next. We're going to wait because they're still preparing in the back. They are need their time to get ready. So we're going to welcome them when they come on stage. But in the meantime, Mr. Roberts is going to have his soloists come up. I'm going to lower the microphone and you could get to your program that has our soloists. Miss China Coleman, Natalia Gabriel, Angelina Zinnick, and Noah Sharma from Mrs. Delacab and Mrs. Bassiano's class. Let's give a big round of applause to them. Job. Next up on the program, I'm going to turn it over to Mrs. Miriam Burnaby, who is our Director of Arts and Special Programs. We started something new this year, as many of you may or may not know, and I'm going to have Ms. Burnaby talk a little bit about it.
Thank you, Mr. Mastrangelo. You know that part of the mission, actually the main mission of the Arts Department over the years has been to provide opportunities for children to learn all kinds of things. And that started with our support for our music and our teachers. And you have one of the best music teachers that I have ever met in my life, Mr. Peter Roberts. I don't know where he is. There he is, Peter Roberts. Take your bow. He is extraordinary. And in addition, we also like to bring people from outside to provide other opportunities. For example, did you enjoy the beautiful violin and cello exhibition that you just saw? Miss Tatiana Longman. You know, Miss Longo has been with us many years, and this is part of a partnership that we have with the Music Conservatory of Westchester, and they provide other opportunities too. Besides the strings, they provide music therapy and dance therapy. It's really a wonderful partnership. And in addition, something happened last year, just about this time. I got a call from Miss Sheila Davis, I'd love her to hear this, but she's back there getting the ballerinas ready. But she called and she said that she's actually a remarkable lady because she was a dancer on Broadway and she felt it was important that the schools in Westchester have dance programs. And so she called me and we were talking and she said she'd like to provide a dance program for the Greenberg Central School District. And I said, well, we already have a dance program because we do have a jazz program and we have a African dance program starting in Bailey, and we also did some ballroom at one time, and we got it. But she said, well, my mission is to go out and find funders and find money and to provide a dance program. And I was thinking, you know what I always loved, what I would always want to do is to have a ballet program here. And I also know we have a beautiful dance studio at Woodlands. I don't know how many of you know that, but the Freelo Center. Oh my God, here come the baby ballerinas now. Beautiful. So I was just talking about Miss Sheila Davis. This is Miss Sheila Davis over here. And she has a company called the New Professional Theater. And she seeks out funding for these wonderful programs. So she found a wonderful Thompson Family Foundation, and they are the sponsors of this program. And so we sent out letters to all of the third grade, because we figured, what's a good grade to start this program in? Third grade, they're not too young, they're not too old, they're just perfect. So, unfortunately, we didn't get any boys who applied, and I'm sorry about that, boys, because, you know, football players take ballet, and they get very strong. So next time there's an opportunity, I suggest you take that. But that aside, we got these wonderful dancers. We auditioned them, but everybody got in because they're all wonderful. And so here we are. I'm so glad they're out here. I know it's warm in here. I'm not going to take up any more time, but I do want to say thank you so much to Ms. Davis and to the New Professional Theater and the Thompson Family Foundation. And I also want to say a big thank you to Ms. Mamie Duncan Gibbs, our wonderful teacher who has been on Broadway. She is a talented, talented teacher and artist in her own right. And now, your wonderful, beautiful ballerinas. Take it away.
Thank you.
What a great job. And on the days when there was no instruction, I helped. I was teaching them as well, so. Mrs. Burnaby is right, boys. It is a known fact that there are many, many football players in the National Football League who take ballet in the off season. You see athletes every single season on Dancing with the Stars. So dancing is not for girls, dancing is for everyone because, and especially ballet, because it really helps with agility. So hopefully next year we'll see double amount of students, and the twice amount of students will be boys and girls. That would be wonderful. The first Maypole dances will be performed by Mrs. Slotnick, Ms. Wasserman, and Ms. Santacandro's classes, and this first dance is called Circling Figure. So Mr. Roberts is going to get us started. Boys and girls, are you ready?
Yeah!
Are you ready to rock the Maypole? And for those of us who are sitting down patiently doing a beautiful job, are you ready to watch some really cool designs get up there on the Maypole? Yes, you are. And one of the delays, just to let you know, is the top of the Maypole, someone was wearing as a hat at the royal wedding last weekend, so we had to wait for it to come back. Two, three, gently turn. One, two, three, gently turn. Ready, skip, in, not too hard, and walk. Walk, two hands, and walk, one, two, three, gently turn.
So that you can get ready for our next dance. So boys and girls, turn around, change hands, and we're off. And walk. One, two, three, gently turn. That's it. High step, skip. One, two, three, gently turn. Let's hear it for them. Let's go. Let's hear it. our circling figure. Now, boys and girls, hold on to your ribbons. Mrs. Delacama's class is coming to take it, as well as students from Mrs. Barone's class. So just hold on to your ribbons, and we're about to start the second dance on the Maypole. This is called the Spider's Web, or the Tent. Once somebody has taken your ribbon, you can walk back to your seat. Thank you. As you will see, this dance that we're about to do is in waltz time. It's called the Spider's Web. We will make a beautiful design that resembles a diamond or a spider's web or a tent on the Maypole. Just about to set and get ready for some fun. Face your partner. One's going to be walking clockwise. Step in, step out, step in. Go around and under and meet your new partner. Go, step in, step out. In, around, under, now without me, go. Stop right there. Ladies and gentlemen, the Spider's Web. Boys and girls, turn around. Ones, you're going to be walking counterclockwise. Let's do a little waltz. Step in, step out, step in. Go around from the outside. Go under your partner's ribbon. Go halfway around. Step in. Step in. Go around. Go under. Go halfway around. Without me, guys. Go! Let's hear it again, guys, for the Spider's Web. Our next dance is called the Barber Pole, and it's supposed to represent or look like an old-fashioned barber pole. Have your cameras ready, ladies and gentlemen. This is gorgeous. Twos, please move in. Gather. One's turn, and we're going to be walking clockwise. We're ready, and begin. One, two, three, gently turn. in your lane. On the maypole concludes with this plaiting or braiding figure that Mrs. Ratner's class will now perform. There's an old-fashioned English word called plaiting, and when I was growing up, I heard it all the time in relation to my sister's hair. my parents used to say, oh, we have to plait her hair. I was like, plaiting her hair, braiding her hair. But it's really a braid, and now it's coming back in fashion. Plaiting, we're going to plait, P-L-A-I-T, plait the maypole. We're gonna braid the maypole. Here it goes. Step in place, and let's urge them on, guys. Let's urge them on. Let's go. Let's braid the maypole. Ready? One's out. One's in. One's in. One's in. One's out. 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 One's in. Gentlemen, we just braided the maypole. We have now braided the maypole for the year 2018. Let's hear it from Mrs. Ratner's class and friends.
Let's hear it again for all the Maypole performers. I told you it was difficult. Think about it. Could we really have done the barber pole, ladies and gentlemen? No way. No way. I'm going to lower the microphone for Armita Mohaza, Inanna Wilson, Zelina Toro, Rachel Udobe, the soloists to Blue Green Hills of Earth. Boys and girls, you know that song, right? Okay, here we go.
Thank you.
Public speaking and public singing might be two of the hardest things anyone can do. Let's hear it for those soloists. Miss Peterson's class, can you stand and get into your positions? Now, we're now going to take you to Scotland. And we're going to do a dance called the Shottish. One of the characteristics of this dance is, well, two things. Number one, it's a couple dance. Number two, there is a little bit of a hop, which we're also going to try to demonstrate in the dance. And then the title. The title is called The Road to the Isles. So, the word Isles is short for islands. And the road that we're talking about is a road that will lead down to the sea so that people in Scotland, on the mainland, can go to the different islands surrounding Scotland. Thus the name, Road to the Isles. And I will join you, guys. That was lovely, and thank you for the dance. When I think of Ecuador, or when I used to think of Ecuador, I never thought of slaves, I never thought of Africa, and yet there was just that in Ecuador. With an African influence, especially on the coast. This next dance, and you'll hear it in the music, is definitely Ecuadorian. It's definitely Spanish sounding or Hispanic, but it also has the African influence. And let's watch this bailecito, un bailecito de Ecuador. To your place. I'd like to give our garland dancers just a moment to get ready. So we're going to now turn to recorder music, music for the recorder. So the two classes that have their recorders, please take them out now. And what you're about to hear are instructional pieces for the recorder. The fact that they're beautiful is also lovely, but these are instructional pieces for beginning recorder players. And this year we have learned to play and read three notes on the instrument and on the music staff. The notes are B, A, and G. If all goes well, we will also learn two more notes by the end of the year, the notes D and E. Right now, we're going to have two classes perform selections for recorder. Can those two classes stand, please? Ms. DeLillo and Ms. Dariano's class, and can you face me, please? We will start with, what's in your bag? B, A, and G.
Thank you.
solos for the prelude come up, please? We're gonna play one quick piece called Prelude, and then we will end with the Glory Train. So Emma, please stand. This is from Suite on Three Notes by Kenneth Simpson. Now we will hear Ms. Dariano's class play that same piece. So Ms. Dariano's class, please stand. The next song is called The Glory Train, and this particular song is a spiritual that comes from slavery, but it comes from the Underground Railroad. The words, I see the glory train coming, refers to Harriet Tubman and the Freedom Train. It's not something where they were hoping to die and go to hell. So we will play this piece as the last piece on the recorder. We'll play it twice, and then we'll sing it, and then we'll play it again a couple of times. The Glory Train. Thank you. a Garland team called the Highview Garland Dancers. What else would they be called? Or the Junior Falcons. So we're ready for our Garland dancer, accompanied by the accordion. Let's end with a waltz. Those children that practiced the waltz a little earlier, including those four or five from Mrs. Martin's class, please come forward and let's end with the waterfall waltz. Mrs. Slotnick's class, please stand. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for coming to Maypole 2018. And we will end with a waltz. Thank you. Step in, step out, waterfall. Step in. Wait, now step in. Step in. Step in.
That's a great way for us to finish our springtime Maypole assembly. I want to thank you all very, very much for your patience. Our assemblies are typically 45 minutes to an hour. Today was an hour and a half because we had so much talent to perform today. They did an amazing job. Let's hear it for all of our performers today, second and third grade. And to Mrs. Burnaby, Mrs. Duncan Gibbs, thank you very much. And a special thanks to Mr. Roberts. He plays the piano. He plays the accordion. He does weddings, birthdays, and bar mitzvahs on the weekend. So if you need, please give him a call. He is, however, booked until 2021, but he is worth it. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, we want to thank you very, very much for coming today. For those of you who are going to try to make your way out of the parking lot, take your time. Good luck. Just make sure you're out by 3:20 because that's when the buses come. We hope that you have a very, very wonderful summer if we don't see you anymore. Boys and girls,